Hi guys, it's me again. Today let us talk about an electron in a uniform field. So let's say you have two set of plates, a positive plate and a negative plate. Positive and a negative plate. This one is positive. They are separated by a distance d. Let's say the distance from this end to this one is d. Of course, if you have plates like this, there will be an electric field from the positive plate to a negative plate. I'll only draw a few. And let's think about this for a second. Let's say I put a positive charge somewhere here. What is going to happen? Because it's just next to the positive plate, it will repel, therefore it will force this positive charge to move towards a negative charge plate. So it will move to this direction. So you'll end up having a positive charge somewhere here. And let's say you apply an external force now. You push this negative positively charged back to where it doesn't want to sit. It doesn't want to sit here, and you're pushing it in that direction. So you apply a force, an external force, let's say FEXT, which is an external force that you're applying, pushing this positive charge upward. So if you're pushing this positive upward at some distance d, you are doing some work. So we have the work done, which is going to be force, which is the external force in this case, multiplied by the distance d. A distance d. So according to the definition, we know that E is equals to the force divided by the charge. So we can solve for F. So the force is equals to E times Q, which is nothing but the charge multiplied by an electric field strength. So this can be written as F is equals to Q times E. So we substitute in our work equation to get what is the work done. So the work done is going to be, you substitute F, is going to be Q E times D, which is the work done that is needed to take this charge from the negative charge towards the positive charge where it doesn't want to be. So if you have done some work, then one can ask you what is the velocity of this particle just before it hits a negative plate. So remember, if you are doing some work done, you're pushing it up, it means that you're giving it some potential energy. So your work done can be represented as a potential energy, EP. So at the top it's the potential energy, and if you release it as the distance decreases, it means the potential energy is converted to a kinetic energy. So EP is converted to a kinetic energy, which is EK. So once you have a kinetic energy just at the bottom here, you can determine the velocity. So if you determine the velocity, it's simple. So EK is going to be equals to the work done, and we have determined what is the work done, which is QED. And from the mechanics, we know what is EK. It's half mv squared. So you can solve for V. So V is equals to, you divide by M, multiply by 2, is going to be 2 QED over M, then you square root and that's how you calculate the velocity of the particle just before it hits the negative charge plate. You can also determine the acceleration, by the way. So if we assume that the positive charge is moving between an homogeneous electric field plate, therefore we can determine the acceleration. Remember, according to the Newton's second law, F is equals to ma, so a is equals to F over m. We know what F is. We know what F is, then we can substitute. So it's going to be QE over M. So that is the acceleration. So let's see, instead of putting a positive charge, let's put a negative charge, which is an electron, for instance. Let's say you have a negatively charged plate. And you have your positive plate. And I put a negative charge E here, which is an electron. And of course, the electric field lines will be in an opposite direction from the positive to the negative. Then the electron will move towards your right to a positive charge plate. So we know that F is equals to Q times E. Then we can rewrite this as small letter e times E, which is nothing but an electron, which is negatively charged. Therefore, an acceleration can be rewritten as E equals to EE over M. So if you want to determine what is the velocity that will take from this negative charge to move to a positive plate, therefore we can use the equations V squared F equals to V zero squared plus 2a change in x. If this is the distance covered from this position to that, from the negative plate to the positive plate, it's d. Therefore, our change in x is the distance between the two plates. Remember, the initial velocity is zero because we project it at some velocity v. So it's going to be zero. Therefore, the v final can be given as 2. Instead of A, we substitute, it's going to be EE over M. DX is your distance, D, then you can root it out. So your VF is going to be the square root of 2 EE over M times D. So that's how you calculate the velocity if you have an electron. Now let's complicate things a little bit. You have your positive plate and you have a negative plate. Of course, the electric field lines will be from the positive charge plate to a negatively charged plate. So let's say you put an electron which is a negatively charged. And you force it with some velocity, initial velocity. Because the electron is negatively charged, it will go against the field. So it will move in that direction. And with inside the field, it will start to project. It bends a little bit, it go, and outside the field, it start to go straight. Inside the field, it deflects a little bit, and it goes up, and outside the field, it becomes straight. So if you look at this, it's what we called the projectile motion. But in this case, it's in the electricity. In electricity. So you can determine what is the initial velocity, what is the final velocity, and if this is d, the distance from here to here, let's say it's d or x, then you can determine the distance it takes before it start to bend up, and you can determine the time, you can determine the velocity as we just done, you can determine the acceleration. So let's simplify things a little bit. You have your x and your y. So in your x, you have your initial velocity. Remember, it has an x component and it starts to go up. It means it goes towards your y component. Therefore, in an x direction, you have your v is zero. In your y direction, your initial velocity, Vy, is equals to zero. An acceleration on an x is equals to zero. On a y, you have an acceleration, Ey equals to, we just calculated this. You also have your x component, therefore you can calculate your time, how much time it took from an initial position until it start to project. Therefore, we can use any equations. So your change in x is going to be Vox t plus half Ax t squared. But remember, we don't have x. We don't have acceleration on an x direction. Therefore, your change in x is going to be VO x times t. So you can solve for t. Remember, we just said our change in x is d. Therefore, d is equals to VO x times t. Therefore, t is equals to d over VO x. On the y side, we can use the same equation. Change in x is going to be VO, change in y rather, is going to be VY times t plus half AY times t. And we don't have the initial velocity. So change in y is going to be half AY t. So we know what is AY. AY is EE over M times T. So we can solve for T. So we can solve for T. Change in Y, half A, but we also know what is T. T we just calculated. So EE over M times, this is T squared. It's going to be d squared over VO y squared. So you can determine what is your d, what is your VO x, what is your e, what is your m. So you can just use the kinematic equation to determine the velocity or the distance. Let's say this is distance d at some angle theta. So you can determine what is the time it took from an initial position and where you start to project. You can determine the acceleration, you can determine the velocity. So we will do one or two examples to see if we still follow.